By Canada Diagnostic Centers, offering MRI, X-ray, and ultrasound services in Calgary and Okotoks.
423 Canadians are diagnosed with colorectal cancer every week. 175 die from it. Mm-hmm. Health specialist Leah Sarich joining us now with how the disease can be prevented if it's caught early enough.
That is the ticket right there, if it is caught early enough. So colorectal cancer is the second commonest cancer in both men and women, and you just don't hear that.
No,
because,
not
of course,
at all.
It often involves body parts that people don't really like to talk about.
Sensitive
area.
But
we're going to do that here today on Breakfast Television. So 90% curable if caught early. So that is a big number, and you can't do that with a lot of cancers. So we can do that with colorectal cancer. So it's just a question of awareness and prevention. So I spoke with colorectal surgeon Dr. John Hine about what colorectal cancer is and where it exactly occurs in the body.
Colorectal cancer is a cancer that occurs between where the small intestine ends and where the anus is. So it can be anywhere in that range. So it's lower bowel. It's the most common site of a GI cancer. So the GI tract has about 26 feet in it from mouth to anus. And the 3 or 4 feet that is the colon and rectum is actually the commonest site of cancer. So to put it in perspective, the small bowel is about 20 feet long. Colon is about 3 to 4 feet long, and in a year I'll see about 250 colorectal cancers, and I may see a small intestinal cancer once every 2 to 3 years.
26 feet long,
pretty amazing
from
when you think
to anus,
that's right. It's a pretty long stretch. Colorectal cancer is a genetic disease, so you can't alter your genetics, of course, but you can certainly alter the progression of the disease, because colorectal cancer starts out as polyps in the small intestine, in the GI tract, and those polyps can be removed before they progress into cancers. So it's all about awareness and proper screening, so doctors can find and remove these polyps before they become cancer.
The most common way right now to screen people is to start over at the age of 50 for what we call average risk people. So those are people who don't have first degree relatives with colorectal cancer, and to start screening them at 50. And currently we recognize two ways of screening that are efficacious. One is to do colonoscopy, and the other is to do a stool test looking for microscopic amounts of blood that's called the FIT, or fecal immunochemical test, so FIT. Those are the two most common ways.
There is also a genetic test that they can do, but that's reserved for very high-risk people and a very select number of people. So for the average population, you want to get a colonoscopy at about age 50.
Sure.
And, you know, Dr. Hine recommends in Calgary, you're going to wait for a while to get a colonoscopy if you have no symptoms and you're at average risk. So he's saying, let's raise some awareness about when to put your name on that list. So when you're hitting 48, 49, talk to your doctor,
get on the list,
so you can get it done at age 50. But let's be very clear. If you have symptoms, let's review those symptoms. So blood in the stool, pain with defecation, sudden weight loss, changes in bowel habits. If you have some symptoms, you're going to get a colonoscopy sooner, certainly. Mm-hmm. Also, if you've done that FIT test, the Dr. Hine test, so that's the stool test where they're looking for trace amounts of blood in the stool. If that comes back positive, you are going to get a colonoscopy very quickly, so within a month or two. So that will happen. And also, if you're at high risk, so you have a first degree relative with disease, you're going to get a colonoscopy sooner as well.
Awareness, you just talked about that. There's a big campaign on right now.
Yes,
right?
There is a campaign on right now, which is why we're talking about it right now. It's got a great name. It's called the Top to Bottom Campaign.
I like that.
It's a good name. And it's a little bit different than the average sort of gala fundraiser thing. So what they're doing is basically, if you donate $250 or more, instead of having to go to the Hyatt for the rubber chicken dinner, you can actually get a gift certificate to a participating restaurant right here in Calgary.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's kind of a different idea. It's kind of great. All the information, of course, is on my blog. And the wonderful thing about this fundraiser is that 75% of the net proceeds go to local initiatives. So initiatives right here in Calgary to help these patients and these doctors.
Very cool. Yeah. Leah's blog, by the way, breakfasttelevision.ca.
There
good
go.
Stuff. Colorectal cancer. Curable.
Curable if caught early.
If caught early enough.